And welcome back to North River TV. Here we're going to demonstrate the Zenith Royal 790 Super Navigator. This is a radio direction finding portable made by Zenith in the mid to late 60s. It features long wave, the AM broadcast band, and short wave from 2 to 5 megahertz. This radio is fairly unique for a portable, as the ferrite antenna is on the outside of the unit. It rotates a full 360 degrees. And this radio really was meant for, or designed for, radio direction finding. Of course, features a tone control here on the bottom, tuning control, band switch, a dial light, which sometimes works and sometimes doesn't, and what they call a DF level, direction finding level, which is more or less just an RF gain control. We'll fire up the radio here and give a brief
demonstration. If you decide to sell, your money will be sent immediately to you for your
needs. This isn't exactly one of the cleanest examples around. It's got some paint specks on it. It's a little dirty. It's been around. This is a particular model is a Royal 790M.
1-800-728-3425 or visit empirediamond.com.
Demonstrate the RF gain or the DF level. This radio also has a tuning meter as well for aid. Here. Zoom in right on that. And we turn down the DF level control. And we turn it up and tell the deflection on the signal meter as we tune across the band here.
Steve Nash, 15 with 11 assists, but he knows the Suns have really accomplished nothing yet.
It was fun to see the shots go, but
for over 60 years, paralyzed veteran.
Zoom out here real quick and we'll show you from the top here some of the features of this particular radio. Of course, it has the Morse code built or listed right on the ferrite bar antenna. It has a little compass here, which isn't really a compass, but it just gives you an idea if you know where north is. And for this demonstration, I'll point it roughly about where north would be compared to where how the radio is situated here. And just following the instructions on the front of the radio. Tune station for maximum signal, which means we will rotate the antenna. Set the DF level, which means you'll bring it down until you can get a very good indication of the maximum signal strength. Actually, this particular model wants you to set it for the minimum. Okay, and that's what we will do here. Turn the DF up all the way. And then we will check our bearing, which we can kind of see. I don't know if the camera can tell. Maybe if I can get a light on there. is about 290 degrees, or roughly west-northwest. And this particular radio, or I'm sorry, this particular station that we have tuned in right here, which is AM 740 in Toronto, that's pretty close to the actual bearing to their transmitter. That's very close. So that really zeroed right in on it and gave us a good bearing as well. We have, tilt this up here, we have sights as well, so you can look through the end of the, you can look through this little slot here and get a degree bearing on land if you were, say, out at a boat, or if you needed to find a place on the horizon to get a good bearing. But this is a nice way, if you know where your transmitter is, and if you can identify north, true north, this is a great way to find a bearing if you need one. And there were a lot of radios out like this in the 60s, used primarily for marine use, but they also made a bunch of portables as well for hikers and campers and whatnot. Of course, you put the broadside of the antenna to the signal and it brings it right back. Our dial light, which also lights up the compass bearing on top. Turn this around. Of course, on the bottom here, genuine top grain cowhide leather, a real leather case for this. We will zoom in on this real quick. Of course, the schematic, it's a Royal 790M. The original owner paid $104.95 for it and bought it on November 15th, 1968. I really dig it when the original owners write that information down. It's very valuable if you don't have that. Also, looks like they made a couple of transistor substitutions. This radio has plug-in transistors, so you can literally just pull them right out of the socket and replace them on the fly if need be. And you can see those right down here on the chassis. These plug-in transistors, and there's a few on top of the chassis as well. This is a radio built in Chicago by Zenith, American made, hand wired. This is from the pinnacle of American engineering, in my opinion, right here. Quality made. As you just, you will never see this again in America. Everything now coming out of Southeast Asia. Well, that'll do it for this demonstration of the Zenith Royal 790 Super Navigator here on North River TV.